kind of get into it.
Yeah, it is. Here we are dealing with a curved top, which requires a little bit more for you to be a little bit more careful, right? Because it's easy to get everything wrinkled. And some wrinkles, you can see here from the top, like you're doing now, that I have wrinkles, but they add, they don't distract. But in a rounded spot like this, if you just go fast, 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 you're going to have too many, and then it can be distracting. Okay. That's really cool. You know what would be fine? I would like to know from our audience today, if anybody tried this at home.
Yeah.
Yesterday.
See how their projects went.
Yeah, it would
Send us a picture.
Would be awesome to see. Okay. Okay, now I'm going to start mixing a little bit with the color I have inside. I have green on the outside, but I have earth tones on the inside. So I'm going to mix so my border doesn't screen too much. From most crafts, I think that the really fun part is to play with colors, right? So I'll get this one, similar to the ones I have inside.
I like that color.
I like the color a lot. Don't really remember which color we used, but I think it was a red. Do you like surprises at all?
Yeah.
Good. Me too. I don't have an issue with that. So I do like to try new things, and whatever comes, I'll try to use as long as it's not terrible. So that's why I like freeform everything. Even when I do my crochet pieces, like I have a course here with amigurumi dolls, they don't follow a pattern. I create them from scratch because I like the surprises. They all come with a different personality, a different way. Okay, see, we're almost done. And it hasn't even been what? Not even 5 minutes. So you see it's quite fast.
It can be quite meditative too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
After a stressful day, that's the best thing you can do. Okay. Well, I know I have spots in the bottom and inside that are not totally covered, but I have to take care of that later. I want the border to be done. And hopefully I don't have to come back here to the border unless there is an issue with the colors. But it becomes a lot easier once that is done. What would you do after you glue all this? See, I have a tiny piece here. I don't know if you guys can see at all. Let me see if I can.
Just a little edge.
It's a little edge, and it's already stiff, right? Because I did that yesterday. I just cut it out because it's never going to glue okay if I try to glue to the side. So you're going to put at least 3 coats of the glue mixed with water. And what you're doing is really protecting the paper and it becomes more resistant. Now, if you're going to use this, for example, to put fruits on, you might want to put a water-based varnish that is safe. It's not the kind of thing that you can wash a lot or
Right, you'll want to make sure that your fruit's clean before you put them
in
there.
Yeah, yeah. It's more of a decor item than anything else. Remember I told you, you can even make jackets out of this? Well, yeah. I don't know how. I have to tell you, never tried. But guess what I'm going to try?
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
I have an idea of what it could be. Because you can get an old jacket that is, for example, nylon, and cover with coffee filters. It would be a lot of work, but it would be worth. The thing is, the perceptional value of these pieces are quite high. So if you go to sell, we can talk a little bit about the gourd purses, for example. Easy. There are, if you were going to sell one of these, it would start in the hundreds.
Really?
I've seen several in the house of 300 or more. It all depends on the work that you put into that.
Okay.
So for example, if you cover with the coffee filters and then you paint or you carve, because you can carve those too, then you know it's going to be more. But people pay that. And I was talking to a friend of mine, and he was saying about a hotel in Vegas, mm-hmm. that they were crazy about getting horses like this to sell.
Yeah.
But it's hard to find people that make them.
Uh-huh.
Right? But it's a great idea. You say,
yeah,
oh,
no
you
kidding.
Know, when the end of the year, for example, is coming, why not make some extra?
Now,
and it doesn't take that long.
Here's a great question from guest number 327. Could you flatten the bottom of the styrofoam by trimming a little off before adding the coffee filters to make it sit a little more upright?
You could, of course.
Yeah.
You have to work with the styrofoam cutter, which is nothing but a nylon thread,
mm-hmm.
that you warm. When I was young, this sounds so bad when I say that, but when I was a lot younger, I used to just get a knife, put it in the fire, mm-hmm. a little bit, so it's hot. It cuts like butter.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's not complicated. The styrofoam cutter actually is a lot more messy than a knife, but it's a lot safer.
Okay.
So, and you know, just be aware with all the scraps, you have to be careful. But yes, you can. Why not?
Great question. Thank you very much.
Yeah. And let's face it. Let's see that I make everything and I say, oh, it's not going to work for me because it does this all the time. Nothing stops me than coming here, doing that cut, and covering with the paper
and
again.
Do it again, yeah.
I mean, before I put 3 coats of glue, of course, but... Okay, so we got the whole border. I have some air here. Now, what do I have? I have some spots, right, that are not covered, not a lot at all. So then I can choose, I want to...